I'm German. My father is a carpenter and had a company producing furniture. So I was also studying carpentry on so one side. On the other side, I went back to school and studying ergonomics.
Water, has it directly, I guess, so it means it's a balance? Or
balance. Wind and water, something telephone, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, so let's just start a little bit with this presentation, if this is okay for you. Yes, first coming some statistics about the truth of ergonomics, actually. Yeah? Because often you only hear the success stories, but in reality there is also some not so successful stories around, and the statistic is cruel. Yeah? The average lifespan of big companies is less than 10 years. And you can imagine if their lifespan is 10 years, that they 5 years suffer. Yeah. So the curve is not so nice. And new companies, the average only 12 years. Yeah. And here the transformation processes, which is important for you. Change management, some more quality processes. This is more or less all of them, or most of them, are failed due to many reasons. Yeah, maybe one reason that the promises are not kept. The management sitting together, making big plans, big dreams, big perceptions. Yeah, but they are all imaginary. They are not coming down to the ground. This is also a big point, but also in Feng Shui is attentiveness, attention to something, to see the real one, yeah? Not to dream, yeah? Or to make your own vision. And because a vision becomes alive, it becomes reality, but maybe only for you, or for the animal, or for your friend, or for a small group, but maybe not for everybody.
This is now innovation and progress and long-term success can come out of it. Because what you think now might be wrong tomorrow.
Actually, in the long term, and we're not talking about short-term advantages, we're talking about the long-term companies. Actually, this, every manager should consider for a company a long-term strategy, because time is running very quickly, and to develop some new products or processes takes a long time. Yeah? So we need to look long time, years in advance, ahead. The key factor is innovations. Always you need innovations in these markets today. Yeah? You need new ideas, you need the acceptance realization. And innovations are nothing else but applied creativity. So we must then look at what is creativity. I wrote a lot in, this was actually my teaching, because creativity is something which is not just a management factor you need, you can use, yeah? But creativity is some also related to your authenticity. Your own being. You're authentic, and here and now you get this spike, which is called creativity, inspiration. And this is bringing also a joy in you, in yourself, yeah? From spirit
point. And also creates the benefit maybe for the company. And here also, in the company, committed people, engaged people, to find their heart, that they want to go with you, share your vision. And another point is the employees. You want to have a safe place, yeah? So safe, what is safeness, yeah? Just maybe think of the opposite. If you're not safe, you don't know where it makes money coming from, you don't know where you live, maybe what is the future tomorrow. This is not safe, then you are in stress. Stress, all stresses cost energy. So if you imply stress on your employees or on yourself, you are losing energy. You are not 100% doing your job, so you cannot be so much successful. You have stresses which are unconsciously, consciously, you're always aware of this must look on this way and this I must fix and this and this. Oh my God, sorry. You see? If you split your mind in power like a computer, you are multitasking and all stresses are little tasks. And the services running in the background and taking off the computer power. Interesting also people who develop and growing people. This means people who are not already finished with learning. Have everything and don't want to learn anything. You must find people which are open to new things, which are open to want to learn new things. And teamwork once more. So then we worked with a guy called Sascha Kutler, and he also wrote a book about the Archimedes principle, and actually he was walking in this path to stage. Jakob's path, and we heard about it. We start somewhere in France, in Germany, and go back to Spain. The traditional way of, I call it kind of finding yourself, you know, finding your way, walking many.
Pilgrim's path,
yeah. And he walked this and then he wrote a book and he had this idea to split for potential development, potential analysis, quality management, some other kinds. He had the idea to split into the business into three factors. One is the inspiration, the spiritual force, the driving force of innovation and leadership. Yeah? The vision of the managers or the vision of the entrepreneur. The second force is the people. People we call the emotional force. It's quite interesting wording. It also colors when it's good, but it's green. Emotional force. So, and this is what is driving the business. Here's only the vision, this is the dream. Here is driving the business, and the last one we call processes and tools, the physical force. This is your organizational structure, your operations, your strategy, your quality management, your buying departments, or whatever. And you made a questionnaire of 3 times 20 questions, yeah? about this. And then you can put it together in a software program and then you see how the company is. Okay? Here you see that only this one is quite good. Yeah? So he's treating his people quite nicely. They have a nice environment, maybe they have a nice team. But he has no vision and he has no good organization. So this company cannot make profit. So the goal, the aim we need to go is that everything should be balanced. It's functionally balanced. That means round. Like when a wheel can term and this is excellent if you are outstanding. This is actually what is here. And if this is excellence, it is us striving for outstanding results. Okay. So you want to come here. Quality leadership, total quality management, and awards. Excellent. In this way, yeah? And here we have the whole picture. So you can also find everything in the internet. By the office.com and can download this presentation and use it. And also some more kind of literature about the new model, about other things that have been you can just download, you know, about the office.com. First thing is, it started with the search of excellence. Someone wants to make a question, what is excellence, and I'm searching for it. And this started here, 82, with these two guys, and they wrote 8 principles out of it. They're quite interesting. Productivity through people.
And
not just people, all people. So this is what they found out, that it is all, everybody, if you can be excellent, yeah? Need to be involved, need to be engaged. Everything, everybody. This is a new school. I think this is the main context. But this model, you cannot implement in the company. It's just a vision and the first time they introduced business excellence to the public. And here the European Federation of Quality Management, they make a more practical model to implement business excellence. It's called quality management, and they differentiate into facilitators and results. This you can measure and this you can implement. Interesting is here also partnership and resources. So they go even a step beyond their own company. So they go outside their own building. Yeah? Because we have vendors. Yeah? We have customers, okay. If you always as a manager you look for customers and you learn a lot how to satisfy the customer, how to work together with the customer, get ideas to change, modify your program, how you see the customer, and so on. But also we have vendors. And we have one. One example in Germany. This is Kurt Werner. You know Kurt Werner from Jem Chocolate Markets. From the English word was strawberry, probably. Got some not a pharmacy, but then you can find a hidden power in China. And cream, everything. And he has a special business model. And just for his career, yeah? It's a big tabletop, and you can not break and damage the transportation very easily. The packaging is not an internet shop out there, which is producing boxes like here, and you can pack, you know, you can send this transport. So it's made only for you in solid bamboo. Finished very nice, but it's made in Anji. It just came from Anji to Jinko. And the base here in Hangzhou was come from Hangzhou to Jinko, and then an installation guy must come and install it together. Yeah? And the chair is coming from another location. So how do we expect that this product finally installed can be the same price as at the beginning when you furnished two or three floors in 100 of them? But I don't know why there is no interest and no. I want like a little child. And Kenya is, when you go to Kenya, they have management, quality management processes, and I think the management is really doing good, you know, they are really going for awards. I don't know the name of which awards they want to know, but they're really going for awards. Go there, everything clean and everything much organized, and people they want to just be waiting for this award, you must keep this. But on the other side, what is missing there? The understanding of the cooperation of these, that is another for our other slide. The whole partnership. And partnerships with your vendors, with your customers, with service people, with everything. This is a kind of partnership because these are resources you need and they are part of your company. You must consider this. Yeah? And that is why the buying department, I don't know, something is wrong with this manager, or maybe you must teach some better ideas or to improve the buying departments to become more integrated in the role of the company. The office is the same. Yeah, this was already the same. The office is a desk and a chair. It's not creating an efficient office. How can you say that this desk and this chair can improve the communication, the teamwork in the office? Yeah. If it cannot, to improve teamwork, you must make some social groups, you must make some facilitators, some objects that you can maybe stand and communicate. Yeah. Also, you must make sure that the people are secure. If you are sitting in the office and someone comes to you, oh, how are you? Yeah. So this is stress, this is what you don't like, yeah. And you're sitting here, yeah. I'm coming now and want to ask you something, yeah. So I'm coming here. You're comfortable. But so, yeah. So something must be here that you can have a link. Communicate, yeah? So I invite you to feel comfortable. Even what you did is to hide the seating level. Yeah? Make a high adjustable desk and put them on a higher level. And then you have special chairs which enable the open angle seating, so you sit in a very high position. And this is also then improving the communication. These are little tools. And there are many, many tools in the offices you can use to facilitate special functions you want to achieve, like communication, like more focus on your work, more concentration. Yeah? Reduce stress and reduce illness factors is one thing. It frees up energy. Next thing is to facilitate the inspiration of vectors and especially communication and teamwork. Mm-hmm. Can I just take over to my other four? My interest is Feng Shui, or shall we go to how much time actually does it have?
A lot.
You want to know something a bit different about Feng Shui or which subject? Because
I think it's quite interesting. I should know. I think Feng Shui is definitely interesting. And I think you should do it. You still have a lot of time. It's 10 o'clock. We still have, let's say, 1 more hour. Yes. Including all the questions. I guess if you don't take the break, then we can finish a bit earlier. Do you agree?
Yes.
But please ask some questions if you have some, because I guess what Mr. Peter is talking about is very connected to what we were talking about during this course since the beginning of the semester about employees. We talked a lot about leadership, maybe we still didn't come to that part. We said that leadership is the key for companies for creating the environment. Always has to come to the top. For those individuals, they make wrong decisions, as you said, purchasing department. But I guess again, I would ask CEO, because he should be responsible for them. Some top management have to put them in line with the strategy. But please, this is very interesting. I guess there will be some questions at the end.
Yeah, if you want.
Yeah. Let's do 5 minutes later. Really 5 minutes, not your 5 minutes. 25 minutes.
Where are you recording this, Louis?
I'm just gonna annoy you.